on our way down to the barn with our baby quail chicks who are finally feathered out. They were born the weekend of Thanksgiving. It is now the week before Christmas, week and a half before Christmas, sometime in December. I lose track of the dates with this pregnancy brain. Ryan, what's the date?
Today is the 15th.
The 15th of December.
So 10 days.
So how old are they then? If they were born the 20-something of November. Anyway, they're feathered out now and they're moving to the barn brooder, which is an old crib that we converted into a brooder that we use for all of our chicks at certain stages of their life. And this is the stage they're at now. What you got there, Rowan?
Mitzi.
She's pretty relaxed and chill, huh?
Yeah.
She went down?
Yeah.
She's such a nice kitty.
I know.
She likes following us down to the barn, doesn't she?
Mm-hmm.
Just a little ragdoll kitty. Whoa, that's a lot of pumpkins.
I know.
Whoa, what are we going to do with all these?
We are going to crush these pumpkins for the goats.
And that's right.
And these pumpkins are bats full of pumpkins. There's literally like 1,000.
Yeah, that's a lot of them. So these right here on this side are all the heirloom pumpkins that we're going to try to eat most of or save seed from for human use. And then all the jack-o'-lantern pumpkins that we are giving to the goats. We've got a whole bin of them over here. They're back there. There's just pumpkins everywhere. I guess that's one perk for working for the compost company in the city of Atlanta. Huh, Ryan?
Yep.
Be careful. Watch your toes and fingers.
This doesn't work.
It doesn't work. Yeah, it's hard to break open the smaller pumpkins, actually, because they're not as hollow. Two hands on that hammer, please.
I did that.
Thank you. I can tell the ducks have been in here. Ryan leaves me a bucket of water just in case anybody's water has duty in it. And you can see by the feathers and the mucky color that the ducks came in and dirtied up this water on us. Ducks, you have your own bucket of water right there to drink. Why don't you just drink from that? So these two ducks are all that's left of our free range. The other two Muscovies that we got from Robert at Daybird Aviaries unfortunately fell as a meal for bald eagle, guys. We have a bald eagle here now. So these two ducks have been staying really close to the barn or in the barn at all times now, of their own choice, obviously. So we need to get a lot more Muscovy on the ground. They're a heavier breed of ducks, so typically they're harder for the birds of prey to get, but we still have to have some free-range ducks out here to help control our snails and slugs, even if we have predator issues. Believe it or not, those ducks are actually part of the beneficial ecosystem we try to maintain here at Wholesome Roots. They are protecting our goat herd from meningeal worm. Meningeal worm is passed through a host of deer and then slugs and snails. So to keep meningeal worm out of our herd and keep them safe, it's imperative that we have free range ducks. You girls thought I was bringing you something, Nami. They are looking so healthy and so good. Everybody has got their winter coat coming in or already came in. They're all looking nice and plump. We've been giving them extra hay all the time, as much as they can eat. So they enjoy that. As you guys know, I mentioned in a previous video, Fancy Girl had a parasite issue, and you can see she's already regaining her weight. Her ribs are looking nice and full again, so she is on the mend.
What, Titus? What is it, Titus? I would come in there, but you would get me muddy with your big muddy paws because you're just not a very well-trained pup about jumping on the mama.
He used to be. At least he doesn't jump on me. He used to be really good about not jumping on me when he was younger. And it wasn't until he was older that he started jumping on me. And he's very jealous of my pet, Glazy.
He
He pushes my hand back to him. Yes, Glizzy, you know you're the sweetest. She's the sweetest. She's very passive, and he's very not sweet. They balance each other's personalities out lovely. Good dog. Good dog. Yes. Yeah. Oh, you're gonna go play now. Okay, go show us how you play. Oh, so handsome. Oh, he's so handsome. Uh-oh. Usually he yelps when he touches that fence, even if it's not on, he knows what it feels like. So he is naturally afraid of it. You can see Kitty is getting round and fat. So we have some goats out here that are about 3 months pregnant. Look at that wide load. She's definitely bred just by looking at her belly. Not sure about Shady. Haven't seen any signs of her coming back into heat or her belly growing, but she's chewing her cud. Is that you humming? Ruby is definitely bred. She's developing an udder already. Here she is with her sweet pea. That's her daughter from last spring. And I'm excited to see what she does. Yeah, she's looking pretty wide. Not sure if Shy is bred. I have not seen her come back into heat, but I also have not seen any changes in her size or udder. Truly came back into heat, unfortunately. We are not going to breed her right away, though. We're going to wait, I think, one more month. I need to look at my calendar and allow her to rebreed then, because if I do it now, then she would be due right when I am due to have my baby, and I don't want to have that happening. That would be difficult. Dominique has developed one side of an udder, so I think she's bred. It's kind of weird for her to have just one side on an udder, but, like, you know, who knows? She's a little weird one. Fancy too, this black goat here, she has been coming back into heat as well, so her and Julie will be saved for a later kidding, and they will be the ones that will take us through the winter with milk. So they'll have summer kids. For some reason, Fancy 2 has always had a summer kid. Liam, you wanted to join us?
Yeah.
Who you got there? Sweepy?
Yep.
She your friend?
Yeah.
She's a friendly goat. Who else has got you? Who else is sniffing you? Flower. Flower looks like she could be bred. This will be her first freshening if she is. She's kind of wide, but she's always been a really wide loaded girl. Fern is the same. She's a first freshener if she is bred. So she's looking pretty big. I'm 99% sure Time is bred. She's already looking really wide. So good.
But Mom.
Good looking. Yeah. See, it's more so on the right too. So she's definitely bred. What about you? Are you bred?
I wanted
no,
to
you're Rosemary.
Me.
What am I talking about? Rosemary's not bred because I didn't breed her. She has a baby on her when we were breeding, so I was letting her baby have all the good milk. And Fancy Girl, I don't think we bred her because I think she had a kid too. Yeah, she had Scrunchie. What do you think, Time? Hearts hasn't come back into heat, but she does not look very big. But Hearts is the one who surprised us with a baby the year that she had her first kid. So she doesn't look any different in the udder either. But she didn't really produce very much milk, and she didn't take care of her kid the first year, but we were not aware of her being bred. So we weren't doing all of the extra supportive care of extra feed that we normally do. So,
I don't know
if it was due to that.
You scared me!
Is Time trying to taste your hair?
Yeah.
Because you got messy hair. Who's that?
How did you get
you
here?
You snuck up on us!
I'm a sneaky ninja.
And Autumn was following you. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
She's my partner.
She is.
Mama.
My ninja partner.
Ninja partner.
This is really important.
Autumn is not red, obviously, but...
Brooklyn didn't let me smash my own pumpkin.
He didn't let you smash your own pumpkin? Why not, Rowan?
Well, I wanted to help him.
Oh.
And I didn't know if I could I didn't want to interrupt you, and I didn't know it's okay if I smashed my own pumpkin.
Oh, okay. Well, thank you for not interrupting when you weren't sure if it was okay, but don't take your brother's pumpkin. That's not nice either. Now that Ruby's standing up, you can see, look how big her right side is. And you see her udder is already starting to get a little chub. So excited. So excited. Some of you are probably wondering, why don't I just go ahead and have the pregnancy test done so that I know for sure? Really, it's not that important to me to know for sure. I have enough that I'm pretty confident are definitely bred that I'm not worried if a few of them aren't. Also, it's kind of out of the timeline that I would breed them anyway. By the time I start wondering who's bred, it's usually when I can either tell or it's too late to do it again. So I'm just like a little more laid back about that. At some point, maybe I would get more curious if there was a different reason involved, but I have enough goats that I can have a few bred and a few bred later on, and it'll work out just perfect for our milk consumption. The really sad news is we dried off time, so now we have no milk for 2 months. They start kidding schedule around Valentine's Day, so February 14th is when I'm expecting some of them to be due, and then it's goes for a little while after that, several weeks of reattempting for some of them, and some just weren't ready at that time. So we'll have a good staggered birth rate, I think. I think we'll have little clusters where we'll have a couple kid and then there'll be a little break and then a couple more kid. So it should work out just fine for our schedule, and I can't wait to have milk again. The boys have been actually really upset and kind of going on a strike about drinking cow milk. They're like really not too happy. Let's see what they say. Let's see. Hey guys, can you tell me what you think about cow milk?
It's not that good. I think goat milk is way more better. Oh, 100,000 times better.
Yeah?
Yeah, goat milk is the best milk I know.
What do you think about goat milk versus cow milk?
Goat milk.
Yeah, what do you think of the cow milk?
X.
That's one way to put it. I've had a hard time getting Rowan to even eat cereal with his cow milk. And he loves cereal.
This one is pretty fat.
Yeah, she's gotten pretty fat. She's a sweet girl, too.
It's the same as Wait. Whenever you look at the same pattern of a baby and a grown up, and then it's probably their parent. Is that correct, Mama?
Sometimes.
Okay.
All right, are you boys ready?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm gonna put these quail into their new home. This is our chick brooder. It's a converted crib. We have chicken wire and, what's the name of that other stuff, Ryan?
Hardware cloth.
Hardware cloth on the outside, chicken wire on the inside. We also have it covered with feed bags on the very outside to keep the cold air from coming in the winter. What do you think, Liam? Did we do a good job?
Yeah.
And it's lined with feed bags and then a layer of pine shavings. We have their water and their food close by to the light, because the first couple of days they're probably going to stay pretty close to that light, even though they have all their feathers.
Hey.
Got her.
Yeah. Remember, try to drop it down on its feet. You're going to have to drop it from a little bit of a height, but they're okay with that. Good job. They've been flying out of the little box that we had them in. Oh, you calling for your friends already. That's the sound they make when they get out of the box. And they're like, wait, I'm alone. I didn't mean to fly out. So they sure are cute. And they are social animals. The boys have been playing with them a lot.
One, two, three,
These were
four.
Hatched out of my friendliest quail hen I've ever had. She's a Texas A&M. And she is the only quail I've ever had that actually wants to be petted and held.
One, two, three, four.
I think I'm seeing a lot of her personality in these babes. What do you boys think? You think it's because you were holding them so much, or do you think it's because their mama's so sweet?
I think their mama's so sweet.
Oh, that one doesn't want to leave you.
All right,
so Rowan did six, and Liam is going to do the next six.
Okay.
So once they figure out where their food and water is, try to get them lower. They're pretty hardy little birds. They've been handled a lot by these boys.
Put them over by the light, Liam.
Liam, where are you going with that one?
I think we should put a drying box in there.
Don't touch. All right, let him get another one. Yeah, let go if it's flappy, okay? Just let go. This is a perfectly acceptable height for them to fall from, and it won't hurt them because they have gotten so big. Of course, we want to go as gentle as possible.
I think they are
all those beautiful white snowballs, and here's the one dirty snowball.
The very last one to hatch was a brown chick, and it's half the size as the others. It hatched like 2 days afterwards, too. It was a day after. The one that hatched 2 days afterward, unfortunately, didn't make it. It was also
on top of it.
Yeah, we'll put a lid on top.
And then we'll put the lid on top. That's right. We built this lid for the top. It's not very predator secure, but we have been very lucky, knock on wood, that it hasn't been an issue for us in any of our years of raising chicks so far. The really cool thing about this particular crib is we got it from a daycare, and it had clear plexiglass ends, so we can actually look in on the sweet babies as they grow. Right, Liam?
Yep.
You love watching your babies?
Yep.
And there they are, finding their food and water, staying cozy under the light.
I love you, babe.
You guys are gonna miss your babies, aren't you? You've been so bonded to them in the house.
It'll make them want to come to the barn more.
Yeah, you're gonna have to do more chores with mommy so you can check your birds every day. And it looks like they're comfortable enough away from the light that they're coming all the way down here. So I think the temperature in there is gonna be just fine.
Oh, I'm flying.
Yeah, they're gonna practice their wing flight now, just like they have been in the living room. On the really, really cold nights, we'll put a blanket over this end, but not near the heat lamp. It is a Premier One heat lamp, which is the safest heat lamp in the world.
Hi, guys.
But we still don't put anything touching it.
Oh, no.
No wonder that one's a boy. Tends to be the noisier ones, huh?
You're not your cute.
Trying to get a few more things done before the light fades. The sunset is already happening at like 5:30 now, so we've got a couple of goats that have to have their hooves trimmed. One's got a slight limp and the other one has a hoof issue we've been trying to correct. So we're gonna go ahead and knock those out before it gets all the way dark. The goats are already pacing at the fence line knowing that it's close to dinner time. So a few more goats to do. And then we can let everybody in for the evening. I just wanted to say, if you haven't noticed, this awesome hat, one of my lovely subscribers that I got to meet at the Homesteaders of America conference, sent us all nice, cozy, soft, perfect hats. And I love them. I love them. Everybody loves them. Everybody got one and everybody is so in love. The boys took theirs off when they started playing and got warm. But I've been being lazy and making Ryan do all the hard work. You get to do that when you're 5, almost 6 months pregnant. That's right. I am at the 20-week mark. And here comes Limpy Girl. We're going to check out what's wrong with her hoof and just hope it's just a little trim that we got to do and no hoof rot or anything like that. Right, Fancy? Yeah. I just needed a little trim. Her feet are dirty because it's been muddy, it's been raining,
But when I scoop it out, I'm not seeing anything that looks or smells like hoof rot. She just needed a little trimmed off. But it's her front that she seems to be limping on, so there could be a worse rollover, or she could have a pebble. Is it that one? I don't wanna. Yeah, she stopped eating as soon as I lifted up this foot. So she could have a pebble that's trapped in that little curl. All right, so there's some mud. So it's hard to show you guys really good, but it looks clean. I don't see anything that would be causing any strain. There's no irritation between her hooves. So it could have just been a little pebble that I didn't even see as it fell out. So I'm gonna guess it's probably that. I'm gonna, you know, do all 4 feet and make sure, but I didn't see anything that was alarming. She just needed a good hoof trimming, which they all do right about now. So we're gonna do a couple every day until we get all caught up. I had Ryan jump in to do this one because she started leaning into me. That's the hardest hoof to reach. Something to think about if you're setting up your milk stand is setting it up where it's not against the wall on one side because then that side of the goat is hard to reach. So he's getting that one cleaned up. How's it looking?
Yeah, it's all right.
So nothing out of the ordinary. You know, one of those pieces that I clipped off her other foot, it made a louder sound when it hit the milk stand. And I almost wonder if it wasn't a pebble falling out. So hopefully that's all it was. And she will start walking a little more smoothly. She's just kind of been bobbing her head and seeming like it's a slight limp in her front quarter. So we'll see after this. She's sure is shiny and fat though. Happy girl. Well, as you can see, it got dark. Night has fallen at Wholesome Roots. And we have finished up with our major task that we needed to do today. So we feel good about that. And the goats are definitely ready to come in. Ryan's just topping off their minerals. Minerals are super important. Make sure that it's a high copper mineral. And we like this brand particularly. It's what we can get locally that's they seem to enjoy.
Yeah.
So we just make sure that you always have that fresh and available. We do it in their stalls because if we do it outside, if it happens to rain or dew, it gets ruined and they won't eat it. So it stays nice and fresh and dry in the stalls. These boys back here are being naughty and disobeying us and climbing on the tractor. But they're having fun and they're being really careful, right?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And they're gonna get a good bath tonight and sleep well after helping with the chores. Thank you guys for watching.
You know the drill.
We'll see you next time on Wholesome Roots. See you next time.
See you next time.
Peace out. Please make us have the, please make us have the maximum number. Nintendo Switch.
No. Say bye.
Bye. Bye.
Are you boys comfortable? Is that where you're gonna sleep tonight? Your bath. You're gonna take a bath in squash and pumpkins.
Yeah.
You love them that much, huh?
Yeah.
How many pumpkins and squash are you gonna eat?
So I'm gonna eat more pumpkins and squash.
Oh, okay.
Like three.
Okay, that's all. Man, we got a lot to eat. Nanite goats. Nanite goats. Nanite goats. Nanite goats and your birdie friend who for some reason is staying in the nest even in the middle of winter. Looks like the quail have settled in just nicely.